Who is this? Oh, Ubitus? And oh, this is already off to a bad start. I haven't done anything yet, and I'm already annoyed. This is gonna be grand. Well, welcome everybody to another edition of GWC Plays. I don't know what I'm getting myself into here. So, Square Enix was smart enough to include a demo of those Kingdom Hearts cloud versions. I'm gonna check them out. I gotta see how these cloud versions are. I have been burning it on Twitter and just talking about this, of just how ridiculous it is that we finally get the Kingdom Hearts series on Switch, and it's in the worst possible way. So, I'm gonna check it out. Play demo. You can use this application to try out the game for free. I don't care. The game will start soon. Please wait. Things I never wanted to see as a loading screen for Kingdom Hearts. This game will start soon. Please wait. That's the sign you would see when you would put a game in for the Dreamcast or the Saturn, where the game has to load for like 8 minutes. Or shit, no, going back to old, going back to Commodore 64, where the game has to load in. Like, I have no hopes for this at all. Because, okay, it's kind of lagging already. I have not entered gameplay. Okay, now here's the most important choice, a small demo. What game do I start off? Do I go classic? Or do we go all-time classic? Now, Kingdom Hearts 1, I'll get into gameplay quicker. Kingdom Hearts 2 is going to be a bit harder. So you know what? As much as I love KH2, as much as it's one of the best games of all time, we got to rock Kingdom Hearts 1 because it'll get into gameplay quicker. And I will say, it's already lagging. I have not done anything. I am in the menu. This already is off to a bad start, and I haven't done a goddang thing. And is inherently the issue with why I was so against a cloud version of this. Because they expect everybody to play this game with incredible internet. Listen, no one has good internet. Very few. So, I don't know who they're expecting this is for. Because my internet ain't good. And I know a lot of people's internet ain't great. And some places, you know, some people might not even have internet. So you know what? I guess they're screwed. They can't play Kingdom Hearts on the Switch. And there's a myriad of things, too, that kind of suck with the situation. Because not only is it cloud only, it's only streamed. So you buy the game. One, you don't really own it because it's not physically on your Switch. It's on that server, which, hypothetically, one day, if that server ever goes down, well, you're not playing Kingdom Hearts 1 again. Two, you can play it portably. I could pick it up right now and play it handheld mode. But here's the thing. If I play it in another part of my house where my internet isn't as good or as strong, the connection's going to be worse. And the second I decide to say, you know what, I'm going to leave my house and keep playing this, nope. You are pretty much tied to only playing this game at home, which is so against what makes the Switch great. Like, I remember a long time ago, before they ever announced this collection for Switch, I was saying, I will buy this game again just for the simple fact of being able to play Kingdom Hearts, the entire series, on the go. I still almost hoping that Square decides, you know what, we were stupid. Here we go. Digital, you can buy it and play it. Because there's nothing, I don't know why it had to go this route. Because Final Fantasy X HD and X2 on the Switch, they run great. Final Fantasy 12 also on the Switch, that runs great. It's on PS4, runs good there. So it's like, you know what, I don't know the excuse. The only game I could see being on the cloud is KH3. Because obviously, that's a pretty big game. It's a lot of things to it. It makes sense. But 1.5 and 2.8, 2.5 is where I'm like, okay, this could run. It's like, Square, you really should have put the money in, because it is such a shame that the worst way to play this game is on the Switch, when it should have been the best. I will say, even though it's lagging, hey, this intro, still great. Still greatest. This song still hits. But, you know, I don't know if it's in the video, because you know how YouTube is. Tani Hikaru, hey, I remember back in the day, like, before people were complaining about music stuff on YouTube, hey, don't put the intro of Kingdom Hearts 1 or 2 up on YouTube. You're getting your channel deleted. But where was I? Oh, yeah. Square, what are you doing? I guess the one positive I can say is, you know what? It feels kind of weird to be playing this game with a Nintendo controller. Just like it would have probably felt weird playing this game with an Xbox controller. But... Now, I will say this, and I've probably stressed this in the past before. I am a diehard Kingdom Hearts fan. I've been in this series day one. I've played all the games. I have like 5 copies of Kingdom Hearts 1. Okay, let me see. Okay. Seems okay so far. I'll say that. But every so often, it just starts to hitch a bit. And it's just enough where it's like, it's like, this is the kind of game you really don't want the frame rate to start dipping. Especially when you get to the later games, because there's certain battles where you pretty much have a fraction of a second to react. And I'm speaking specifically when you get to like Kingdom Hearts 2, because these are running off of the final mix version of the game. It has all the secret bosses and everything. And those bosses require a little bit of like precise stuff at times, especially if you get to like the final secret boss. So I don't even want to see how that's gonna play. But not even that, there's a mini game getting into Birth by Sleep, the PSP game. There's a mini game in that game where it's a timing one, and I remember on PS3 when I played it, it was horrendous how bad the timing was. Like, it took me, 40 minutes to get through it, because for some reason, like, the timing was off. And it's kind of precise. It was fixed on the PS4 version. Maybe it's because bumping it to 60 helped. But it's lagging for me pretty bad. And that part requires good timing. So, I'm worried. Alright, you got it. Okay, I just want to get into battle. And the thing is, and maybe it's not going to be as apparent if you're watching this. Maybe it will be, but on my end, it still looks good. Like, hey, I am not like a graphics guy, but I can just tell slightly it's a little fuzzy because it's streaming. It's not like direct in from the Switch. Like I said, still great looking game, but that streaming thing is just cutting the quality down just a little bit to where it kind of comes out fuzzy. But that's such a slight thing. But I think it's coming off of... Oh. You hear that audio lag? Now I am playing off my soundbar, which does, I think, have a minuscule little bit delay. But that seemed like full-on bad lag. Oh, I gotta turn my soundbar off just so I can fully articulate that maybe my hearing isn't bad. Okay, I'm on my TV speakers now. I had to lower my audio quality to see, because that sounded like it was a little out of sync. And you know, maybe this isn't the best video, because it might just seem like me, like, shitting on this for like 30 minutes, being like, oh man, it's so laggy, it's this and that. Listen, I was the biggest defender when this announcement first came out. Although I will say that when that announcement first came out, I've never been so deflated before of just it's cloud only. And I'm still pretty like up, but I was like, you know what? I will at least, when the demos come out, I will give them a try. If my connection is good enough, I might go for it. But as time went on, I'm just like, oh no. Because my internet's not good. It's just like, nah. I would rather go against my best interest and get the Epic Games version of this. Cause like right now, this is the worst way to play it. Legit. You are better off going to a Goodwill, a local game store, going and buying a copy on PS2 and playing that one. You will get a better experience. Or shit, go get the PS3 version. You can get that now for like $20. That's not a good version that well. Like it still runs, I think, 30. It's a little slow at times. I know Kingdom Hearts 2 is really bad on the PS3 version. It has like a bunch of new glitches and slowdown for drive forms. But it's like, you know what? At least it's not this, where it's just throttling and lags every once in a bit and the audio's off. It's really a shame too, because this is Kingdom Hearts 20-year anniversary. And this is the legacy that it's has. It gets on a Nintendo platform, like main games, and we get it in this state. Like it's such a shame that Square put no effort into this, because it, like, they had to outsource it to some other company. It's like, did they? Like, this could have easily been on the Switch native, and it sucks, because I recall there is an interview I read where someone from Square said, hey, we're looking into possibly getting, maybe listening and maybe seeing if there is people who would want it digitally to buy it. And it's a shame that that went nowhere, because had they said, you know what, we decided the cloud version is not working, all right, we're going to go and actually make it available for at least 1.5. Because number three, if 3 was the only one in cloud, I'd be like, okay, that's fine. I have the DLC and all the stuff on my PS4, so I have no problem going there. But for me, it's number 1 and 2. Being able to play those on the go is where it's at. All right, well, I've seen what stuff is here for this one. All I'll say is, it's kind of hit or miss. Like, at times, it plays pretty good. Like, right now, it's like minuscule. But there are those points where it starts going off. I'm just like, ooh. Wait. Before you stream. It's funny it made it here. Because at least it made sense on PS4 and Xbox. And it's like, obviously, you could stream it internally on the systems. But seeing it on the Switch is funny. Because, like, you'd actually have to have an external card and do all that. Which, obviously, these days now is pretty common. But it's just funny that this message also made it onto there. Actually, you know what? I'll kill Darkseid and then we'll move on. I think I have to check out 3. Because that's the one where I'm like, okay, 3 on the Switch might have some problems. And I think I actually picked a good time to play this, because it's running pretty smoothly. Like, there's been those occasional hitches, but it's not as bad. Like, I tried Hitman 3 a while ago, and it played like garbage. But just seeing this, like, man, this game could have... Square, do you not like money? Because the one thing that's going to suck is, if this doesn't sell well, Square's going to think, oh, well, I guess there's no want for Kingdom Hearts on the Switch. It's like, no, we want it on the Switch. I want it on every system. Shit, put it on my phone, put it on my microwave, put it on my smart fridge. It, it, if there's a place I can play Kingdom Hearts, listen, I will be there. But they're making it hard. It's like they put it on the Epic Game Store. They put it on the Switch and Cloud. They decide, all right, we're going to put the Final Fantasy Classic series only on Steam right now. Not on the Switch or any of the other consoles. It's like, okay, that makes sense. You hold the mightiest weapon of all. I do. The home button, where I can close the game. Whew. Okay. So, that was 1.5. But the real one, KH3. This is the big one here. This is the one where it's like, okay. The other ones, those are PS2 ports that were ported to from PS2 to 3 and then onto PS4 as well. This is the one that exclusively was built from the ground up for last-gen systems. And yes, I will now fully start saying last-gen. I'm talking PS4, Xbox One. Even though everybody's still in last-gen because no one's got a PS5. I know like two people who have that system. But here we go. Services started for Kingdom Hearts 3 Remind, which that worries me because it says services started. Like, at some point, you're going to see the service for this game has been shut down. Do you get a refund? No, you don't. So I'm just scared. I'm just scared for that happening. But moving on to Kingdom Hearts 3, which, hey, you know, this is the third time I have played this game in some form on the channel. Although this is the worst form I've played it on the channel. But it's like, you know, we're back again. I can't get enough of this game. Kingdom Hearts 3 was a legendary game for me. I did love it. I will say that. I was one of the defenders when the game came out. And you know, I still am. I still really, really do enjoy this game. I'm still much anticipating what's coming in a few months for Kingdom Hearts news, but also even like kind of the future too. Now, I would love to sit here and watch this intro because I think legit every time I played the game the month it came out, I sat and watched this every single time. The only time I didn't watch it was the first time I played it because I was scared of spoilers. But for today, I will unfortunately skip it, which mostly means at the second I finish recording, I'm going to go watch it on YouTube. Now, is it going to be the just regular Kingdom Hearts 3 one, or is it going to be the Remind one? Okay, just regular Kingdom Hearts 3, just raw Kingdom Hearts 3 intro. Advent Red, all right. I guess until you buy Remind, you don't get that. All right. New game. It's just standard for now. There's no point. My friends are my... All right, let's see this loading time. Let's see. Yeah, and there it is again. Like, it's such that small, minute thing, but, like, it looks a little fuzzy on my end. Oh, Kingdom Hearts 3, they're like, all right, we're going to just skip everything. Like, that skipped a whole cutscene. It skipped the intro. They're like, nah, right in the gameplay. Which is, like, kind of happy, but at the same time, like, man, I kind of wanted to hear that intro. There are 7 hearts to save. Boy, did that line come true. But this isn't the spoiler talk of Kingdom Hearts right now. Use done a move on camera. Okay, this one I will say, comparatively to Kingdom Hearts 1.5, which that one, for the most part, is pretty consistent with how it looks on PS4, just not as sharp. This one definitely does have a little bit of a nerf, graphically-wise. Just if I... Like, it's just, like, a little fuzzy around the edges. obviously this is the worst way to do it, just being like, all right, if you zoom in, because obviously if you zoom in on anything, it's gonna look like that. But this one, definitely, I can just tell a little bit, even from where I'm at, that it's a little fuzzy in that area. But it's fine. This is still a great looking game. Like, at this point, it's just pixel peeking, which I don't really play that too much, but it's more since it's streaming it, where I'm gonna kind of like play that. I'm just not a fan of this cloud version. I just wish I could buy this and just own it. Ah, remember that classic moment? Oh, I guess hopefully you beat Kingdom Hearts 1. All you getting spoiled. You know, this is unrelated from this video and talking about the cloud version, but I still can't believe that there were people legit who were like, you know what, I'm gonna play Kingdom Hearts 3. My first game in the series is gonna be Kingdom Hearts 3. I'm not gonna play 1, Chain of Memories, 2, Birth, any of them. And then had the gall to be like, this game is confusing, this story makes no sense, what is this? Like, it's your own fault. You should have... You can't go into, like, a movie or something without any prior knowledge of just a series and expect the movie to tell you everything right there. I didn't walk into Return of the King without seeing the other ones and then be like, wait, what's this? What's the ring? What's a Frodo? It's like the dummies who were like, yeah, I saw Endgame, but I had not seen any Marvel movie since Iron Man 1. Just like, why? You could have at least watched a few of them. Watch the important ones. Because then they based that in their review or their thoughts on it. Like, listen, you can't get any kind of... I ain't taking your review seriously. At least you played the whole series. I can at least say, hey, you played the whole series. If you didn't like the game, you know what? It's like, hey, that's fine. You at least have your reasons. But being like, I ain't playing shit. This is my first one. I'm going off that alone. It's like, what? You asking to be confused. Like, you're just asking for trouble at this point. All right, rant over. Although I feel like I've been ranting this whole video. This whole video, I feel like they need just talking smack on this cloud version. Remember that moment? Remember that? Damn, this compression looks like it's really from the Game Boy Advance. It's like I'm playing Chain of Memories on my GBA. Some of this compression on the screen. Nah, that's not fair. That's a really unfair comparison. Choose your playstyle. Wait, what kind of adventure do you seek? Your answer will determine your playstyle. Usual adventure, play without using the DLC premium menu. Play using the easy codes in the DLC premium menu. Use features like auto heal. Play using the pro codes in DLC premium. Use like defense always being set to 0. See, I've never started the game straight up after like the Remind. Which is kind of crazy to think. I once Remind came out, I never did another playthrough again. I might have to change that. Because honestly, after this, it's making me really want to go back and play again. This is the only Kingdom Hearts game I think I've legit only played once, so I should actually play it again. See if get a fresh view, post-hype, post-everything. In retrospect, I still really enjoy it. But I'm... No, oh! Okay, I'm skipping this. Wait, did it? Did it just hit me with the... Or I guess... Okay, I gotta skip some stuff. Hold on. Is this who you are? Yes. Okay, I'm back again. I always forget that these games try and hit you with that. Are you sure? And they put no at the top. It's like, alright, listen. Can developers please stop doing that? I always hate when games be like, are you sure you accept this choice and no is on the top? Because most games, usually it's like, are you sure? And yes is the first option. And no's on the bottom. Like, why is Kingdom Hearts hitting me with that Zelda Ocarina of Time garbage? Where no is yes on the top. And then just to mess with you, they'll put yes on the top. So you instinctively hit the bottom one for no, thinking it's yes. It's just all trouble. See, the thing is, like, even if there were a myriad of, like, kind of things that would have to get, changed to get Kingdom Hearts 3 running on the Switch, like, if the resolution had to be dropped and maybe some certain things, like, I'd be fine with that. As long as the gameplay, is everything is fine in there. Let's see, MP's... it doesn't really matter. I can just leave these on. Okay, some of these are kind of hard. Damn, I need to actually check this out. Like, no cure sounds rough. Oh, that's mean. During battle, your whole team's MP. And HP? Your whole is set to zero. Oh, I was about to start blasting. I was about to start tearing those heartless up. Well, I guess that's what I get for making that mistake. Damn. Well, I hope you enjoyed that demo of Kingdom Hearts 3. I made some selections. I ranted about some stuff, and I didn't play the game at all. Hopefully this informed you and got you info you needed about the cloud version. Aye, aye, aye. So, that's going to be it for me here. Because I ain't playing through that again to get there. And I don't think I need to go back to 1.5. Now, there is 2.8, which I could have downloaded, but it probably would have been the same as pretty much 1.5 and all that. It was interesting seeing Kingdom Hearts 3, though. That one definitely does have a little bit of a downgrade in some sense, just in certain aspects, if I can recall from the PS4. And I think even some of the reflections and just some of the different things going on there, like the aliasing side. But, yeah, you know what? Final thoughts on it, and being real for a second, not kind of the joking thing. This is the cloud version, obviously. It's the worst way they went about it. I think it's really going to depend on your internet connection. I was very, very lucky that when I recorded this, my internet was kind of decent. That meant nobody else in my house was either watching something with like a high bit rate or whatever. Like they weren't watching like Netflix or HBO Max or something. Because I know for sure when I played Hitman 3 and tried the cloud version there, it was like unplayable at times. And throughout the most of this Kingdom Hearts one, you know, it was pretty okay. It was playable. There were little bits of like lag, like drops at times where it would kind of get a little laggy and like it would freeze up, or the gameplay would be a little off, or like the audio. But for the most part, it kind of seemed consistent. But it really is going to depend on the person. If you have like grade A Google Fiber internet, it's probably going to be perfect. It's probably going to be fine. It'll look good. Well, maybe, because there's still going to be the streaming like drop you do get in quality. But I don't know. It's just really unfortunate, because I know my internet is not good to play this whole thing, and I would want to spend the kind of money that they're asking to buy this version that theoretically could not exist in however many years. I'd like to hope maybe that the sales on this thing kind of show Square that, hey, this cloud thing wasn't worth it. They should have actually put the time into actually getting a proper version, even if it was just for 1.5 and 2. But you know what? Only time will tell on that one. I don't have high hopes in that at this point, because it's here pretty much. So I'm about to cut my loss on it. You know what? The only positive I will say is, you know what? Those with good internet, they can play Kingdom Hearts on the Switch. Is it a good version of it? Eh. But they can play it. It gets the series into more hands. I still think it's a fantastic series. I love it. It's absolutely worth playing. If it's on the Switch, maybe Nah. But definitely a PS4. Get it. You got an Xbox One. Get. Oh. Talking this long is killing me. Well, I haven't recorded a video in a year. So I got to get back into it. Before I die, I'm going to call here. So that's going to do it for me here, everybody. I'll see you later on. I'm probably talking about more games. Seeing stuff. What have you. As always, I'm John GWC. And I'll see you later. Peace. Oh, God. I'm dying. Oh, they're about to send me to the cloud right now.